In this video, we're going to work with the interior enclosure of a set. These are two sets defined from a given set A in a topological space X. The interior is defined as the union of all the sets that are contained in A and that are open. Let's make a drawing. If we have our topological space X and there are obviously a lot of open sets, let's say that this set here is A. The interior of A will be the union of all the open sets that are here, that are contained within A. Because it's an arbitrary union of open sets, it is an open set. And obviously, it's a subset of A, because all of these sets are subsets of A, and so their union is 2. And the closure of a set is actually a bit more important, is more used than the interior, and is the intersection of all the closed sets that contain A. Now, if we have our set X and A, then we can take all the closed sets that include A and just take the intersection of all these sets. This set is also closed because we saw in our previous video that arbitrary intersections of closed sets was also closed. And because we're taking the intersections of sets that include A, then A is a subset of its closure. And so what we have is that the interior, which can sometimes also be written as A with a zero in there, is a subset of A, and A a subset of the closure. And now what happens, for example, when A is closed? Well, then A will be part of all this intersection, because obviously A contains itself, and it's already a closed set. And so what happens is that A will be equal to its closure. And what happens when A is an open set? Well, then A will be one of these, because it's a subset of itself and it's open. And so A, in this case, will be equal to its interior. So now let's see a very important theorem that will be extremely useful for us. It will be an equivalent definition of closure, and it's the one that we are mostly going to use, not so much the definition as an intersection of closed sets. So this is the theorem. It says that we have A a subset of a topological space. As usual, we're going to write X, and if we need, the topology will be tau X. So we say that an element of the space is in the closure of A if and only if, and this is why I mentioned it was going to be an equivalent definition, every open set containing X intersects A. What this is telling us is that X is in the closure if and only if for every open set U, that is every set in the topology that contains X, U intersection A is non-empty, because it says that it intersects A, so there is an element in the intersection. So what's kind of telling us? If this is our set A, well, obviously we know that every point in A is going to be in the closure. And so this other property now is also valid, because whenever we take something here, well, the intersection is obviously filled with elements in my set. But this gets interesting when we talk about elements that maybe are not in my set. What happens when I take an open set like this? Well, if this was my point X, this set U is a neighborhood because it's an open set that contains it, and we can see that the intersection with A is non-empty because we have all this. So what this equivalence is saying is that if we can do this given X for every open set, if this intersection is always non-empty, then X is in the closure. So in a way it's telling us that the closure is going to be my set A and this thick border. And no more than that, because if my x was here, then maybe I could take an open set like this, and the intersection of this open set with A is empty. And the second property is actually very trivial once we know the first one. It says that if the topology of X is given by a basis, then X is in the closure of A if and only if the basis elements that contain X intersect A. And this is trivial from the first one because we know that any open set U will be a union of elements in the basis, and for the reciprocal, every basis element is open, so we just use the first property. So I'm only going to worry about proving property number one. And to do this, we're not exactly going to prove this, but it's negation. Because it is an if and only if, we can do this. So what we can prove, like an alternative version, is that an element X is not in the closure of A if and only if there exists an open set U that contains X such that the intersection with A is empty. And this is what we are going to prove. So once we prove this, we have the theorem. Let's start proving this direction. So we will take an element that is not in the closure, and we have to find the open set such that this happens. Let X be an element that is not in the closure of A. Well, X minus A, the closure, because the closure was closed, we know that this set is open. So if X is not in the closure, then it's part of this set X minus the closure of A. And so because it's open, then it's a neighborhood of X, so just denote X minus the closure of A as U. U then satisfies these things, it's in the topology, it's a neighborhood of A. And what happens with U intersection A? U, we said, was X minus the closure of A, and then intersection A. Well, I'm removing the closure, and A was a subset of the closure, so this is trivially empty. I was able to find this open set, this neighborhood of X, for which the intersection with A is empty, and then we have this direction. Now let's prove the other one. For the other direction, we know that this set U that satisfies all this exists, and I have to prove that X is not in the closure of A. So let's take X, just an element in the space, and consider U to be the set that we know exists. So U is in tau X, and U contains X, is a set such that U intersection A is empty. So because this intersection is empty, this means that A is a subset of X minus U. But now U was in tau X, so X minus U is closed. So X minus U is a set that contains X and is closed. So if we go back to the definition, X minus U contains A and it's closed, then it has to be part of this intersection. So that proves that the closure of A is a subset of X minus U. And so because X was an element in U, this implies that X is not in A bar, because A bar is all contained in X minus U. The theorem wasn't so hard to prove, but we had to know what to prove exactly, because proving this would have been very complicated, but not so much proving this variation.